Welcome to a lesson on set theory basics. The goals of this video are to define basic set vocabulary and set concepts. A set is a collection of distinct objects, and the objects can be called elements or members of the set. A set does not list an element more than once, since an element is either a member of a set or it's not a member. We've actually already studied sets when we defined the set of real numbers. Remember, all real numbers are made up of either rational or irrational numbers, and then we can break those sets of numbers into more specific sets of numbers as well. And capital letters are normally used to identify a set. Now, there are sets that have repeated elements, and these are called multisets, and this will not be addressed in this video. So looking at our sets of real numbers again, notice that all real numbers are made up of rational numbers and irrational numbers. So we could call rational and irrational numbers a subset of real numbers, but we'll talk about subsets in the next video. Right now, let's go ahead and focus on the different ways of identifying a set. The first way is a written description. We could state that set A is the set of calendar months beginning with the letter J. We could also identify set A using the list or roster method, where we list the actual members of the set. So set A is equal to January, June, and July. And we could also use something called set builder notation. Set A is the set of all elements X such that X is a calendar month beginning with the letter J. All of these represent the same set. So to describe the set of these three colors, the written description could be B is the set of primary colors. Or using the roster method, we could say that B is equal to the set where the colors would be red, blue, and yellow. Or using the set builder notation, set B would be equal to the set of X such that X is a primary color. There's also a special set called the empty set or null set. This is a set having no elements at all. The notation used for an empty set would be either of these two notations. For example, if B is the set of five-sided squares, since there aren't any five-sided squares, B would be the null set or empty set as identified here. We can also use these two symbols here to indicate if an element is a member of a given set. So for example, if we have set C is the set of even numbers, greater than 2 and less than 12, let's first identify this set using the roster method. So we can't include 2 because 2 is not greater than 2. So we'd have 4, 6, 8, 10, and we would also not include 12 because 12 is not less than 12. So this is our set, so we could say that 4 is an element of set C, 6 is an element of set C, 8 is an element of set C, and so is 10. And we could also say that 2 is not an element of set C, and 12 is not an element of set C. And of course, there are many others. Now let's talk about cardinality. The cardinality or cardinal number of a set is a number of elements in a set. And we normally use these two notations to represent the cardinality of a set. And since set notation does not repeat elements, we just have to count the number of elements in each set to identify the cardinality of the set. So the cardinality of set A would just be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because there are 6 elements in the set. The cardinality of set B would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as well. And the cardinality of set C would be 3. Now, two sets are equivalent if they contain the same number of elements. If two sets are equivalent, they can be placed in a one-to-one correspondence. So if two sets are equivalent, we write their equivalent using this notation here. So looking at these two sets here, we could say that set A is equivalent to set B because they have the same cardinality or the same number of elements. Now we have to be careful about this word equivalent. Often in math it's used when things are equal, but obviously these sets are not equal, they just have the same number of elements. Now this idea of a one-to-one correspondence just means that for every one element in set A, we could match it with one element in set B. So we could match 1 with 2, 2 with 3, 3 with 8, 5 with 11, 8 with 12, and 9 with 13, illustrating the one-to-one correspondence. The last topic we'll talk about in this video is when two sets are equal. Two sets are equal if they contain the exact same elements that may or may not be in the same order. So looking at these three sets here, notice that set A and set C have the same cardinality, meaning they have the same number of elements, and they also have the exact same elements. Set A and C contain little a. Set A and C contain little b. Set A and C contain little c. And set A and C contain little d. So they have the exact same elements. Therefore, the two sets are equal. Set A is equal to set C. The last thing I want to mention is that all of the sets we have seen in this video have been finite sets, meaning they have a certain number of elements or terms. The cardinality of the empty set is 0 because the empty set has 0 elements, but the cardinality of an infinite set we say is uncountable. However, we can use something called transfinite cardinal numbers to describe the size of an infinite set. But right now we're just going to identify the cardinality of an infinite set as uncountable. I hope you found this introductory video helpful. In the next video, we'll talk about subsets. Thank you for watching.